Attention science fans, today we're gonna get hands-on with Charles' Law of Gases, and you only need some kitchen items to join in. So what you're gonna need is some soda cans, you're gonna need a bowl of water, in this case it has cold water, it has ice in it. We're gonna need some safety materials like safety glasses, we're gonna need some tongs to be able to hold some hot materials, a hot pad or safety gloves, depending on what you need. We're gonna need a pitcher of regular water. We're gonna need a large metal can, which Nasco does sell, in case you need that. And then we also need something to help boil the water. So in this case, we have a hot plate. So then you're ready to go for your experiment. All right, I've got my hot plate ready with some empty soda cans. What you're gonna do is add a splash of water in your soda can. Then you're gonna put it on your hot plate. Once it's on a hot plate, it will begin to boil and it'll create steam, right? That water vapor inside there. And you really want to get the molecules moving and grooving. Then once your cold water is ready and prepped, what you're gonna do is you're gonna take it right off of there once it's boiling. You're gonna take your tongs and you're gonna immediately go dip it right in there and cover the hole. Boom! Like a magic trick, it crushes that can. So much pressure. All that hot air trying to get out. Now let's try it again with another one here. Boom! It's like a magic trick. A lot of fun. All right, let's go bigger and bolder. Let's level it up with a larger gas can, right? So, same kind of concept that we had last time. We're gonna use water and we're gonna pour it into the gas can. Got approximately about how much water we're gonna use. That should be about good. And then what we do is we put it on the burner. Once it's boiling, you got that steam going, we're gonna put our cap on. We're gonna seal that air pressure in, and we're gonna put it in to our container. Now I've got some ice cubes in there to really cool it down, but what you're gonna do is you're gonna take this ice water and pour it over. So here we go. Look at that, crushing that can, yeah! All that air pressure going there, about 2,800 pounds of force, forcing that can to crush. It's a great demonstration of Charles' Law in action, showing how changing temperature affects gas pressure and volume. So the next time you boil water or open a soda can, think about all those tiny water molecules doing their part in the grand gas ballet. Thank you for watching this demonstration. I hope you have learned something new.